Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Wednesday last week, SpaceX successfully launched their 109th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 17-8.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1097, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Also on Wednesday last week, SpaceX successfully launched their 110th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1022.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1083, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Friday last week, SpaceX successfully launched their 111th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1057.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 27th time when the drone ship just read the instructions.
Landing leg deployed.
Then Saturday last week, SpaceX successfully launched their 112th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 17-9.
One, ignition, and liftoff of the Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Wednesday this past week, SpaceX successfully launched their 113th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of T1TLB.
1. Ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go SDA.
The booster which launched this mission, B1093, then landed successfully for the 6th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
I'm back, shut down.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 114th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of New Centauri Lima.
One, engine full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go New Centauri Lima.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 23rd time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Just about the same time, Falcon 9's first stage reigniting its center Merlin engine for the landing burn as Stage 2's MVAC engine cut off after reaching orbit.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Nominal parking orbit insertion.
Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 115th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1710.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 28th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Related to the Starlink landing we saw on Friday last week, SpaceX posted about a crazy milestone. They said Falcon 9 touchdown under just read the instructions drone ship completing the 500th launch and landing of an orbital class rocket. Later today and going into the week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the NG-23 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 14th at 11:11pm UTC or 7:11pm EDT. Later in the week, we should see the first of a few Starlink missions launch. The Starlink 1712 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 17th at 4:41pm UTC or 12:41pm EDT. A day later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1061 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 18th at 10:30am UTC or 6:30am EDT. Then a few days after that and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1027 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 21st at 10:20am UTC or 6:20am EDT. Later the same day and we should see a customer mission launch. The NROL 48 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 21st at 6:37pm UTC or 2:37pm EDT. The FAA has approved a couple of things for SpaceX's Falcon launch and landings. The first is that they've approved the construction of a landing pad at Slick 40 to support up to 34 landings per year. They've also given approval for up to 120 Falcon launches from Slick 40 per year, which is up from 50 launches per year. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues around the orbital pad 2 launch site. Work continues on the groundwork for the air separation facility near the launch site. This ship quick disconnect adapter was seen moving to the launch site recently. It was lifted and attached to the orbital pad 1 launch mount. There's a new structure spotted being constructed at Massey's test site. SpaceX are currently constructing what seems to be an apartment building near Starbase. Some dummy Starlink satellites were seen being unboxed inside Star Factory for Flight 11. Cesar Garcia posted some pictures of an interestingly shaped tank that was spotted inside Star Factory. Musk gave some information about their plans for orbital refilling with V3 Starship next year. He said SpaceX will do orbital refilling several times next year with Starship V3. Because we are simply docking with ourselves, this is a much easier problem than docking with the space station, which SpaceX already does several times a year. The B18.3 test tank was seen rolling out of Star Factory recently. Here's a look at the Starship 39 nose cone being worked on inside Star Factory. Here's a look at Booster 12 being worked on inside Mega Bay 1. Booster 15-2 will be used for the Starship Flight 11 mission to become the second booster to fly for a second time. SpaceX posted pictures and videos of it doing a static fire test. They said static fire complete for the Super Heavy booster preparing for Starship's 11th flight test. After the static fire test, Booster 15 was moved back to the production site. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia, Jack Beyer and Gage Telesz for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.